Hello everyone, welcome to Desilicious Kitchen. Today we are going to prepare Rava Kesari or Suji. This is the South Indian version of Sheera, and the recipe of Rava Kesari that we are going to show you today is exactly what they serve at South Indian weddings and events. This is a very delicious recipe and it's also very popular down south. So come on, let's check out this recipe. Have a look at the ingredients. So let's begin by pouring some hot water over the saffron strands and soaking the saffron in it for at least an hour. Meanwhile, we have heated some ghee in a pan and we are going to roast the cashew nuts in ghee until they are golden. And then let's set these aside. In the same pan, let's also fry raisins or kishmish and set these aside as well. Next, let's heat 1 tablespoon of ghee and add 1 cup of rava or semolina to it. We have to roast this rava on a low flame for at least 10 minutes and we have to be careful not to brown the rava. So keep sauteing this rava quite frequently while it roasts. And we have to roast until a nice aroma is emanated from it. So then we have switched off the flame and transferred the rava to a plate. Next, let's heat 3.5 cups of water. So for 1 cup of rava, we have taken 3.5 cups of water. Once the water comes to a boil, let's add 1/8 teaspoon of salt and 3 tablespoons of ghee to it. We'll also add in the saffron or kesar soaked in hot water. And once this comes to a rolling boil, we can add the rava. Remember that the water has to come to a rolling boil before you add the rava. That's when the rava will be properly cooked. And we have also maintained the low flame throughout this recipe. We have added in the rava now and we need to stir this continuously until all the water in the rava has absorbed. So then we will cover and cook this rava for 2 minutes on the lowest flame. Another thing to remember is that you need to add the sugar only when the rava is really well cooked, because once you add the sugar, the rava will not continue to cook and your rava kesari might not taste as good. So remember to add the sugar only when the rava has been properly cooked. So we've cooked the rava very well and now we've added in the sugar. Let's mix the sugar in. Remember that when you add the sugar, the consistency of the rava kesari might become a little watery or runny initially, but then eventually it does thicken again. Just keep stirring this until the sugar gets absorbed. We've also added in the remaining ghee to this. Doesn't this look amazing? At the end, let's add some cardamom powder and the nuts roasted in ghee and mix it in. Our delicious rava kesari is all ready. This is exactly the type of rava kesari that they serve at South Indian weddings and events. The kesari is very soft and it can stay for quite a few days. We really hope you like this recipe. If you did, please try this out and give us your feedback. Like and share this video, leave your comments, subscribe. Thanks a lot.